We saw a lot of new people today in the chat, so we're going to make sure we also cover some things from part one. Part one, we focused on just going through what scholarships are and then also our district scholarships. We highlighted where you can find those, the application and what that looks like. So we're going to go over that. Don't worry, you won't miss out too much. And then today we're going to have a lot of writing time. We're going to have some time where we talk to you about some writing skills. Mr. Lang has a great presentation he's going to go through. And then at any point today, if there's anything personal you want to ask, or there's anything that you just don't want to share out the rest of the class, we're talking about writing personal statements and things, you can always type in the chat to talk to a mentor. We'll go over which mentors are at what site so you know who to reach out to. But you can enter a breakout room, and that means it'll just be a one-on-one. You can talk to us there, all right? And with that said, we'll do a quick intro of our mentor team, and then we'll go ahead and get started. Dow's going to run through a couple scholarships to start us off the right way. So first of all, I'll start. My name is Gavin. I am at CKM McClatchy. What's up, y'all? And I'm also at New Tech High School, supporting over at those schools. I go to Sac State, and I'm stoked to help y'all out. If you have any questions, let me know. I'll throw it over to, let's go, Lang.
All right, hello everyone. The school site I'm at is Luther Burbank and George Washington Carver, and I'm a recent graduate of UC Davis. All right, Daisy, you're next.
Hi everyone, thanks for being here. I'm Daisy, I'm the college mentor for SCS and JFK. I'm from Fresno, graduated high school here, went to Fresno State. Every time I'm gonna say it, I love Fresno State. I used to be a recruiter there, so it's just in my blood to recruit Fresno State. I saw some people already apply there, so you're already doing it right. I want to pass it to Dow.
Dang, she repping hard. Hey, y'all, my name is Dow. I'm a college mentor for, Hiram Johnson High School, the Met, and American Legion High School. There's like two or three of us that graduated from UC Davis, and I'm one of them. So nice to meet you all. And yeah, looking forward to sharing this information to you all. I'll pass it on to Natasha.
Hey everyone, my name is Natasha. The sites that I am at is Health Professions and Rosemont High School. And yes, I also graduated from UC Davis as well, 2018, go Aggies, all right. And I am currently a doctorate student at Fielding Graduate University. So I pass it to Dylan Fisher.
Hey everyone, so excited that you guys are with us today. My name is Dylan Fisher. I'm a program manager in youth development with Sac City Unified. I am a lifelong learner and I'm a product of Sac City Unified Schools. So I have the honor of being able to lead this amazing, amazing team that you guys are gonna be meeting throughout the rest of the school year and that are gonna be supporting you as you go into college. So excited for you guys to all be with us today and good luck on getting these scholarships.
Awesome, thank you team. And with that, just a quick tip before I send it off to Dow. I know you guys are all tech wizards already, but what we usually recommend is having two windows open, the Zoom window on one side of your screen. And then if possible, having, as we follow along, if we give you some links, like the scholarship website, some of those, have that open right next to it so you can follow along as we show you some things. So just a quick tip. But with, without further ado, Dow's gonna run us through a couple scholarship examples real quick.
All right, let me go ahead and share my screen. Let's see, continue and then go ahead right here. Okay, hopefully y'all could all see that. Okay, so let me move this here. So one of the first, we'll be touching upon two scholarships today. So one of the first scholarships that we will be touching upon is the Luella Goff Memorial Scholarship. So this scholarship provides like a $900 fund per year for 4 years, right? And then the application period, you will be, you know, the deadline is January 4th to the 16th. So I assume the deadline would be the 16th of 2021 on April. And the first thing you'll see is the general information. So basically this this contains like background information in terms of how the, basically how the scholarship got its name, right? And then I think it's really important to note that sometimes it tells you important information here as well too. So for example, this it says here, right? The student must be in good standing. A student on probation is considered ineligible for renewal of the scholarship. So some of y'all may ask, what is probation, right? So for each university, there's a GPA requirement. I know University of California, Davis has a 2.0 GPA requirement. So the first time you actually don't, if a student doesn't meet that requirement the first time, then they put you on probation, right? However, if you don't meet it a second time, then you actually get dismissed from the university, which is what we don't want. So yeah, so you must stay on top of your game to for this scholarship, right? So that's specific for this scholarship itself too. And the next section is who's eligible. So applicants must have spent both their junior and seniors in the district high school, and you must be applying or must be enrolled in a four-year university. However, you could also enroll in like a community college and be enrolled in like a program that's meant to transfer to a four-year university, right? So, and then once you eventually finish your transfer process and go on to get your bachelor's degree, this scholarship itself allows you to go to a fifth year. However, your fifth year, you must be attending a master's program. So if you want to extend your education and go for a master's program a year later, this scholarship will also fund $900 that specific year too. So this one's pretty nice. The next section you will see is like the notification of winners. So essentially scholarship winners will be announced at the selected students' high school awards assembly, unless otherwise stated, indicated. Then we'll go and move on to the next portion. So this piece of the application is really important. So there are documents that you have to attach to your application as well. For example, two letters of recommendation. I think if not all, most scholarship requires you to have two letters of recommendation. So this one specifically has one from a teacher or administrator at the student's high school and one from outside school. For example, your employer could be a pastor, youth leader, or community leader. Or I think it could even be one of us too. However, we would have to like know how you work, personally, right? And then the next part is also really, really important is a student essay. So this is kind of like your personal statement, but Lane will touch upon that more into detail later. But essentially this describes your educational and vocational goal and how do you plan to use your scholarship funds. So I highlighted this because this is usually the question that's asked for each scholarship. Then number three and four is just your transcript and your college enrollment. So your transcript, your high school record and the grades of your senior year. And then college enrollment is just your letter of acceptance or your SIR or your submit intent registration or statement intent to register. And then, I'll go ahead and go on to the next one, which let me bring it up here.
Please don't switch it yet.
Sorry, does someone have a question?
Go ahead, Nicholas.
Please don't just switch it yet. I was just writing this down.
Okay, yeah. I'll wait here for you.
You could also take a screenshot.
Yeah, gotcha. And also, Nicholas, we're there on the website. All of this information is there. So this is all going to be something that you can view on your own. And I'll show you that in just a moment.
Oh, I just finished it. I finished writing it down anyway, but thank you.
Yeah, okay. So I'll go ahead and move on to the next one. Let me see here. Okay, so the next one is the Antonio Medrano Memorial Scholarship. So this one, so this one only funds $1,000 for 1 year. Oh no, it's doing that again.
Okay. And now sometimes it helps if you stop share and then go back to the document you want to show now.
Okay, so it's not. Okay, so it's working now, I think. Okay. So this one is a $1,000 scholarship for 1 year and the application period is January 4th to the 16th of April. So once again, you see the general information, correct? So this is just essentially what I mentioned earlier, a background information of why it's called the Antonio Medrano Memorial Scholarship.
Check one more time. I think you're still on Luella M. Goff.
Really?
Yeah. Try again.
Oh no, technical difficulties. Okay, what about now?
Yeah.
Okay. Sounds good. Yeah. So this is just as I mentioned earlier, a $1,000 scholarship for 1 year, and the application period is the 4th of January to the 16th of April. And then, who is eligible? So there shall be one scholarship awarded annually to a student graciating from high school in Sacramento City Unified School District. Applicants must enroll full time in an accredited 2 or 4 year college or vocational school. And then, as mentioned earlier too, like each scholarship mentions its specific details. So preference will be given to students who were enrolled in a bilingual program within the school district. Okay, and then the notification of winners is basically scholarship will be announced at the students, once again, the students' high school awards assembly, unless otherwise indicated. And then we will move on to the letters of recommendation. So once again, the trend is here. You see two letters of recommendation, but I think something that makes this one different is that, you know, one's from an educator and one's from an adult community member who's not related to you. So, and then, let's see, I think this one mentioned a letterhead, but I do not see it. But anyways, moving on. So you will also have to write two separate fine word essays. So I know that most require like 700 to 800 words, but this one requires you to write like two separate essays of 500, which is 1,000. But this one is really different. It's more detailed. So for example, describe the world. You have to write for essay number one, your audio biography, which is describe the world you came from, your family and community schools and et cetera. And then essay number two is describe your leadership role and your potential and capability. And then the second portion of this one is impact of a school educator. Explain your relationship with an educator during your school age years, specifically what were some of your memorable interactions, how did it impact your life? And then once again, you see the transcript and the enrollment as well too. And then let me go ahead and pull up a letter of recommendation example. Sorry, I think it's not sharing. Do y'all see that?
Dad, you have to stop sharing and then go share the new one.
Oh, okay. Give me a second. All right, there we go. So this is a sample letter of recommendation. Y'all don't really have to pay attention to it, but this is essentially like what the person you're asking will write to you as a letter of recommendation. So for example, I kind of annotated some of the sections right here. So for example, the first section is, you know, the writer understand what kind of scholarship it is and mentions the student's participation in science clubs. So this part is the writer has to understand what kind of scholarship it is and why you're applying for it. And the second portion is just basically mentioning the student's potential, what the student is capable of. And then lastly, this is the part that makes the student special. So y'all don't really have to worry about that, but this is just like something that y'all would definitely ask for. But I'll go ahead and just give like a minute or two so y'all can glance at.
And while he does that, just wanted to say for any students who I know just hopped in a little bit late, we're just going over some basics on scholarships and then we'll have some free writing time. If you have any questions, like Daisy said, drop them in the chat. Here's the link to what we're going to be talking about a lot today, our district scholarships. And yeah, just follow along. If you have any questions, let us know, but welcome.
Yeah, and then after this, I will pass it back to Gavin so he could run through the general scholarship application for you all. Okay, with that being said, I'll stop sharing my screen and pass it back to Gavin.
Awesome. And you know what, before we do that, because almost everyone here today is brand new, we didn't have them for the first round of the workshop, we want to make sure we hit on a lot of the stuff that we covered in that first one, so you guys aren't left in the dark. Dylan, did you want to go over how to access the scholarship website real quick? I can do that.
Sure, Gav. Yeah, no, for sure. So thank you again for those who are joining us for the first time, and for those who made it back for the second one, we're happy that you're here with us. So just a quick refresher for those who were here and for those who were not, there's a page you guys want to visit frequently to get support from your mentors. And I just am putting that into the chat now. So that link is where you're going to be able to connect with your mentors if you have any questions, but it's also a space where, oh, I'm sorry, give me one sec. So now I got the bug of Dow's technical issues.
Oh no.
there we go. Okay. So So on this website, this is where you'll find your mentors, and you can connect with your mentors at any time through here. So you would just simply click on their link. So if you needed to connect with Daisy from Kennedy, you would click on the link, and then you can schedule an appointment with her right here. Here's the contact information. It's the same for all of them. If you want to learn a little bit about Daisy too, you can also go into her little bio there. So you can learn a little bit about each of our mentors prior to you connecting with them. But the reason I'm showing you this site is because the resource page is one place you can find the scholarships outside of the link that Gavin gave you for our district website. So you can go here to our resource page, and there's a ton of information. So if you need like FAFSA application walkthroughs, that's all on there. Applying to the community college, the application link is right here. Same thing for the CSU and the UC. The student survey B that you guys should all be completing is right here as well. But then right below that is the SCUSD scholarships. Click on that, and it takes you right to the page that we're kind of walking through now, right? These are all of the scholarships. So Nicholas, when you were trying to take notes earlier, this is all right here for you. So you just click on the scholarship, and all that information that Dow was going over, you'll be able to find right here.
Thank you.
And so once you get here and you've gone through the scholarship, you made sure that it's something that you qualify for based on the requirements of the scholarship. Then you're going to go into actually applying, right? You want to make sure that you have your letters of recommendation already requested, and that you have your essay pretty much written, which is why we're going to go through that today. But then there's an application link that you're going to want to complete your basic information in. The thing that you do have to recognize is that you can't save it. So make sure you have your stuff when you're ready to submit. You can look through here to get some practice to make sure you know what you need, but there's no way to save it on the website currently. So make sure that you're ready to submit with all of your information when you log on to do the application, okay? Just so you can get an idea of what the application looks like and you feel comfortable navigating it, I'm gonna pass it back to Gavin so that he can show you what that looks like.
Perfect, awesome, thank you, Mr. Dillon. And then also, I did notice someone in the chat said they have to go a little bit early. This goes for anyone. If you have to take off at any time, all good, no problem. Visit that website that we put in the chat right there, bookmark it, whatever you have to do. That way, when we end up finished with today, we're going to record this and we're going to upload it so you guys can have access to that and all the materials. And if you have questions and want to reach out, you can do so as well. So make sure you visit that website that Dillon just posted. But let me go ahead and share screen. And boom. All right, perfect. And here we are. Okay, move all this stuff out the way. Awesome. So we just went over where to access it, how to access it. Now I'm going to go into an example of a scholarship. There's tons of scholarships once you get here on this page, and they all have different requirements and things that you have to watch out for. Some are just for one school, like CKM. Some are just for a student athlete. So there's a lot of different requirements. You can scroll down and click on either one of these. You can click on the Read More button right here and see what some of those are. It's going to give you some information, the amount, the application period, and all of that. So, of course, here's your, like, just for this one, I'm going to go into Rise Above. It's a pretty popular one, and for good reason. It's $5,000, $2,000 per semester, all right? And so it's going to give you some GPA requirements. You have community service records, full-time enrollment. 4 years. So sometimes these scholarships are going to be for 4-year universities. Some are for community college. So if you're going to community college, don't feel left out. There are some there. And if you have questions about that, we kind of know, we have a list of some of those scholarships. Let us know and we can tell you which ones, but just poke through them. And once you find out this is a scholarship I want to apply for, you're going to see the Apply Now button down here. Okay. So I'm going to click on that and you're going to see the application. Now, these are for our district website scholarships. These are, for most of them, they're going to look just like this. They're going to be very similar. And with that said, for some of these things, you might want to actually just go into a Google Doc. And if you're writing like a personal statement or an answer to one of these questions I'm going to go over, you can actually copy and paste. You can use these over and over on different ones. And you can tweak them in case they're just a little bit different. But for a lot of these, they're going to be really similar. And that goes for scholarships outside of our district as well. We really recommend you don't start from scratch each time. You're starting from a base, little essay, and then you're tweaking it to meet the word count and to meet the prompt, the question. So real quick, here's what the scholarship application looks like for ours. It's got some student info, so basic name. You guys know how to sign up for stuff, I'm sure. Your student ID, you're gonna have to know that. I'm just gonna ask you your email address, what high school you're going to. This is all basic stuff. College choice, so which college you're gonna choose to go to, and major as well. Parent guardian information, so it's gonna go a little bit deeper into some of your parents and guardians information. Yearly income, so if you already did FAFSA, some of this stuff should be pretty easy. Also, if you haven't done FAFSA, let us know, we got you there covered. Family members, brothers and sisters, if you have any, their school occupation. And then it's gonna get down into really the personal stuff with you. It's gonna ask you about school activities, okay? So that's student government, school clubs, athletic things you've been doing throughout high school. You can list multiple as you see here and then put your grade level. So go through and type those in. Community interests and activities. That's gonna have things like your hobbies. If you were in Boy Scouts, volunteering is a huge thing that colleges and apparently the scholarship committee looks at as well. Very important. So some of these things right here, you wanna type in and indicate your grade level. Don't forget that. Achievements, and make sure you don't exit out. Remember, like Mr. Dillon said, it's not gonna save automatically. So don't exit out when you get here. You know, you're typing in your interests. You know, don't exit out of that page, all right? Make sure you're trying to do this all in one swoop. Achievements, there you go. Listing activity and grade level sets, awards, honors. If you took any like AP classes, that's great. Or what are the other ones for APs? I forget what they're called. But if you're taking some of those advanced classes, even if you're taking like a college course in high school, that would be a great way to put that there. And then we're getting down to some of the free response ones. So personal challenges that you've overcome. This is your time to shine. This is these are all things right here that are just kind of rudimentary. You know, you're just typing them in. These are the ones where you really want to put some effort into it and really let, you know, your story shine and be authentic and be yourself. So personal challenges that you may overcome. We're going to go all over today about the writing portion of these. So today we're going to talk about that. Long-term goals, okay, looking to the future. They want to see, you know, as a student, like, what do they want to do? Do they want to do something important and profound, right? Again, are they going to make my money? Are they going to make, you know, the best of it in school? So you want to pay attention to those. And then also just the things you're going to be uploading. Two letters of recommendation for most of these scholarships. Highly recommend, you know, getting those, even, you know, if you want to apply later on and the deadline is, you know, in a long time, make sure for any scholarship you're applying to, you want to get your letters of rec as soon as possible. So if you don't have two people, one like a school official, like a teacher that you're close to, and the other one from outside of school, if you don't have those two right now, after this meeting, you better come up with a list and think, who am I going to ask? Because that's super important. Student essay. This is really general, something that's you can use for a lot of these scholarships. So make sure you type those things out. Even if you just type it in a Google Doc and just save it, it'd be a great way to go about it. Transcript, that's going to be your unofficial transcript. So you can always get that on Infinite Campus. You can request it from your counselor as well. So it doesn't have to be the official one where it's sealed and in letter. Just an unofficial transcript will do. If you have questions about attaining that, let us know. We can put you in touch with your counselors as well. And then college acceptance. Just want to make sure that you actually did get accepted to a college and you're going to use the money to go towards that. So they're going to have you upload those things. Make sure, just a word of caution, make sure you're uploading those in the correct formats. Here it's a PDF or a Word. So make sure you're doing that in the correct format so it counts. And then really that's pretty much it. So this is a very general overview for this application. And this goes for a lot of the ones on our website. You're going to run across on our website, there are actually community scholarships, which are the ones that are outside. We're hosting them on our website at the district, but they're not the ones that go through the district. So if you click on these are going to have some different applications. They're not going to look exactly like the one that I just showed you now. But really all the same things go into that. You know, put your effort in, make sure you're getting your letters of rec and everything ready. So yes, that is pretty much it for that. Are there any questions that you all have at this point? And anything from the mentors that I missed? I know I talked about a lot. Anything you wanted to double back on?
Gab, I just want to touch on the point when you showed the file format that you have to upload. We have heard from a couple of students that when they uploaded the wrong file type, that it gave an error. And when they clicked on OK for the error, that it recycled the website. So they lost all their progress. So I can't emphasize enough that when Gavin made the point, do it on a Word document answering your questions so that you can cut and paste it over. It's going to make it so much easier. Plus, you can do that over and over again for each of the scholarships you apply for. And many of these questions are very general for scholarships. So a lot of times they just want to hear your story. So that same prompt is going to be asked in different ways. But even in the community scholarships that he was just showing you, many of those questions are exactly the same. So if you have it already in a Word doc, it's going to be easy for you to make little tweaks and to cut and paste it right over. So you can apply for many scholarships once you finish your general packet. So to speak. So,
and before Dylan gets into the scoring rubric and some of those things, just wanted to kind of piggyback on that. And just make sure you're saving these things offline, because ask me how I know. It's really tough when you go through and something didn't save and you lose all that progress. Right. That's really hard. Also, just wanted to mention that there's no limit to the scholarships, how many you can apply for, as long as you are still eligible. If you look at those requirements, there's no limit. So, you know, feel free if you have that really amazing piece, you know, the personal statement you put together, that prompt, feel free to apply as many scholarships as you can. So just a word right there. But with that said, if mentors, if they don't have anything else, Dylan, if you wanted to go into the scoring rubric part, students, if you have any questions as well about what we talked about, let us know right now. But otherwise, we can hop into kind of the scoring part of it.
I'll give a sec for any questions. All right. So I'm gonna talk a little bit just about the scoring rubric. I can't give you, unfortunately, what the scoring answers we're looking for are, but I can tell you this, that you do wanna pay attention to your grammar, right? And so it would be great. It would be a great idea once you finish it to have another set of eyes take a look at it. Family member, somebody you know is good in their English proficiency, or reach out to one of your mentors, and you know, we'll be absolutely willing to take a look at your essay and let you know if there's any grammatical changes that you should make. You do want it to be as authentic and genuine to your story as possible. It is important sometimes to, in these type of scenarios, to pull on the heartstrings. So tell your story, right? And if you want to become a doctor, why is it that you're so passionate about becoming a doctor? If you want to become a teacher, why is it that you're so passionate about that? What is it that sparked your interest and that set that fire for you to be like, man, I have to become a teacher, so that's why I'm going to college, right? If it's something that you've had to overcome, you know, some of the questions are about what challenges have you overcome. All of us have faced different challenges. Many have faced, you know, a lot of challenges in our life, right? So, you know, put those on paper, tell your story so that they know who is going to be the ideal recipient of this scholarship, like who deserves it because of what you've overcome. So you want to pay attention to making sure that you are structuring your essay as grammatically correct as possible. But in addition, make sure that you're just getting your story out there, okay? So that's going to be the most important piece of it. The prompts, pay attention to the question because you want to make sure that you're answering all of the question. Some of them are very simple. They're just a simple question that you're answering with your essay. But some of them are a little bit layered, and you want to make sure that you are answering those questions with your essay, because that's what the scholarship review committee is going to be looking at. So do keep in mind that the folks who provide the funding for these scholarships every year, they are excited to read these stories. They are excited to be able to provide funding for the students who apply to be able to go to school. So it's really up to you as to how you sell yourself on this. And so there's in past years, historically, there's been real low applications for each of these scholarships. So I would say to apply for as many as you possibly can. And I do want to say that if you've applied for like five or six, and there's one that you know you didn't really qualify for, you have all the information already done for it, apply anyways, right? Because the reality is, and I've shared this in the last workshop, I know people who applied for scholarships that they really didn't qualify for, and they got them because they were the only one that applied for it. So you never know. You never know. And so because sometimes the requirements are pretty high, it sometimes discourages folks from applying for it. So just apply anyways after you've applied for all the ones you do qualify for. So that would be my advice to you, is make sure you tell your story, be true to yourself, and have another set of eyes take a look at it after you've completed it. All right. I'm gonna pass it back to Gavin as he introduces Lang. But before I do that, just want to make sure that today, for those who are going to be a part of the writing process, and you're going to take part in this journey of starting to get things on paper, I would encourage you to do it in a Google Doc so that you can have the ability to share with others, to be able to review and make some corrections. Just start getting things on paper today. The worst thing that we can do is sometimes, if you're like me, you'll procrastinate, right? Because you have so many things going on in your life, right? So sometimes you wait to do that thing that's kind of a bonus for you. You'll wait until the last minute. So get it done today, because while you're with us, you could potentially have everything you need to be able to submit your application. And it would be amazing if you were able to do that today. If not, we're gonna be here to support you after this workshop is over with. So you can reach out to the team, and we're gonna continue to work with you. And we'll talk about that more at the end of the workshop. On to Gav, and you can go ahead and introduce Lang.
Perfect. All right. I'm just going to lay out the rest of the workshop just so you all know where we're at, and then we'll let Lang get into it. So Mr. Lang, he's going to go ahead, and he's going to have a presentation he's going to share for about a half an hour. It's going to be a great one that's going to set us up for our next activity, which is going to be some free writing activity. That way there's no excuses. Y'all going to write some of these prompts out right now. And we're going to give you some time. That way you can turn in this application and hopefully, hey, get a scholarship and win some money for college. So we're going to give you some time then, about a half an hour of writing time after Lang's presentation. And then we're going to go over some resources and whatnot. And then for anyone who wants to stick around, we're going to be here all the way till the end of the workshop. Time allotted, which is 5 o'clock for writing time. That's all it's going to be. We're going to give you some time. If you want some one-on-one help, we can help you with that as well. So we're going to give towards the end a lot of that time to you. With that said, though, Mr. Lang, if you wanted to pull up that presentation, we are ready for you.
All right, everyone. Can you guys see this? All right. So what I'll be covering is scholarship essay tips, and then I'm telling you, teaching you a writing guide that I've learned when I was in college. So we're going to start off easily with just scholarship essay essentials. Like, this is the four main things you really need to have. Like, know the deadlines, read the prompt, know your audience, and include real life experiences. And I'm going to expand on this. Okay. So know the deadlines. It's just pretty simple. Just know when your scholarship is due. So that gives you ample time to like write your scholarship. You can start early. And it gives you time to get those letters of recommendation. So because when you're requesting letters of recommendation, typically you give your recommenders like 2 or 3 weeks for them to write the letters of recommendation for you. And that gives them time to like think about you as a student or you as a person, so they can write out a good letters of recommendation. If you give them like last minute, it might be rushed. So and then the letter of recommendation might be generic. I know it's the due date is April 16th here, but like I said, for the scholarship due date, just be on the lookout for it. Check the websites constantly too. Sometimes they do extend deadlines. You guys know how like the CSUs and UC application deadlines were extended during this college application season. Deadlines might be extended, but don't take it for granted, and then it gives you time to procrastinate. Just get it done as soon as possible, okay? For the last resort, for letters of recommendation though, because you know, April 16 is next week, I will have you typically, I would have you guys, as a last resort, just email your professors now or tomorrow, or your teacher, not professor. So now, right now, and then let them know that you're applying for scholarships, and then the due date is April 16th. If they can get it to you by April 15th, so that'd be great. You want a day before the due date to give you time to sort all your information out. You have everything ready, so you can just apply on the 16th. Okay, so that's the last resort. But just start asking for letters of recommendation. And even though the scholarships they're asking, you just need two letters of recommendation. I would advise you to ask more than two people for the letters of recommendation. Get three or four or five people to write you a letter of recommendation, because sometimes things come up for the recommenders, right? Like the teachers, things come up and then they're too busy, so they might forget about you, okay? So having backup is great. So then if one person forgets, you're able to get two, okay? All right, next is read the prompt. So I have some examples for some scholarship examples in the district scholarship examples, where you can see what you need and you can analyze what you're gonna write about. So the first example I have is the Jan and Joe Matisco Student Athlete Scholarship, and this is for JFK only. And their essay prompt is just a single page type letter about yourself. Please include how being a student athlete at Canadian has prepared you for college. So right here, you already know for sure that you're gonna be talking about your time as a student athlete if you're writing this essay right here. You can talk about how your time as a student athlete help you grow as a student, as a person, and how is that gonna contribute to you in doing successful in college, okay? So another example is the Thomas M. Utis Memorial Scholarship. And this is for math and science major only, okay? So this one says personal statement essay must be typed 750 words or less. Describe your educational vocational goals, short term and long term, and how it aligns to the mission of the Thomas Utis Memorial Scholarship, and how you plan to use this scholarship. Like for this, you know that by analyzing this, you know that there's three things you're gonna be talking about: your short term goal and your long term goal, and how the scholarship fund is gonna, how you're gonna use the scholarship fund. So you already know that there's three things you're gonna touch upon, okay? So like by reading these, you kind of analyze a little bit of what you need and things like that. What I wanna point out and is the difference between these two here. You see how this one says a single page, and this one says must be 750 words or less. So that means those are a little bit different, okay? If it's a single page, it's only gonna be one page. So if you double space, or if you put like your name and things like that in double space, you're not gonna have enough page for you to write about yourself. So typically if they're asking for a single page, typically it's not double space, it's single space. And then, so you can write a lot about yourself, okay? Typically you just include a title. And then sometimes if you include your name in the essay, you don't really need to put in your name on the paper. For this right here, it says 750 words. This right here, typically you can do double space because you're not limited by the page. So the word, but just remember that you're limited by the word count, okay? Any questions right here? All right, so the next one is the next example I have is the Antonio Medrano Memorial Scholarship. Dal touched a little bit about this. So you can see here by just analyzing the prompt, it says 500 words or less. But remember you're writing to two essay questions, okay? And each one was 500 words or less. It tells you essay written in Spanish are acceptable. And then the essay one is your autobiography. Describe the world you came from, your family, community, schools, and tell us how the real world has shaped your dreams and aspiration. What is an experience that has occurred in your life that is important and why? So this is just about yourself, and it's 500 words. You may think that's a lot, but that's if it's like double space, that's only like a page and a half. Okay, so it's pretty short. An essay two, you have two options. You can talk about your leadership skill or an impact of a school and educator. Okay, and then you can write. You can choose which one you have the most compelling experience with. Like, because we're talking about writing writing life experience, you can choose which one that your most life experience most helpful to you. And in regards to the Antonio Mandrano Memorial Scholarship, if you, I'll cover it in a little bit. I'm sorry, I'm ahead of myself. Okay, so like right here, you just, like I said, it's kind of like analyzing, like, you know how in English classes you're analyzing what you read. So just right here, you're analyzing what you read here too, okay? So next is knowing your audience, okay? So what knowing your audience means is you're targeting who is reading your essay, okay? You wanna make sure you read the history and the general information of the scholarship you're applying for. If possible, you wanna research the person or organization the scholarship is named after. By doing that, you find out more about that person and or the organization. So when you're writing out your essay, your experiences or your essay is gonna match up to their goals or their it's kind of like their motto or their what they're trying to achieve. Okay, so for example, the Thomas M. Eutis Memorial Scholarship. This one, I just got a quote from it. It talks about how Thomas, he loved math, science and math. And you can also tell he graduated, blah, blah, blah. And he loved trees, the forest, and everything connected with outdoors and nature. So you already know here that Thomas he loved science and math. And that's why this scholarship is for science and math majors. So you already know about that. And he also loved the outdoor nature. So if you're writing this essay, you can touch about how your love of math and science help you explore nature, or you see how there's even in nature there's you can still see science and math everywhere, things like that. Okay, another example is the Antonio Mandrano Memorial Scholarship. This is just an excerpt of what the general information is. So it was established by administrators in front of Mr. Medrano. Mr. Medrano was the principal of Cesar Chavez Elementary School. And then I'm just gonna go to the highlight part. He worked hard supporting the families in his community. And you can also tell preference will be given to students who are enrolled in bilingual programs within the Sacramento district. So you already know that since Mr. Medrano was the principal of Cesar Chavez, and you can already know that Cesar Chavez has a bilingual program. So you know that maybe if you write about your own bilingual experience, maybe the reader of this essay might score your essay a little bit higher than people who don't have like bilingual experience like you. He also put how he worked hard to support his family and in his community. If you're a family person, and then you can talk about that, how you helping your family or helping your community in your bilingual community, things like that, or help you grow as a person, okay? Hopefully this helped answer your question. So like reading the prompt and knowing your audience, it's just by reading the essay, general informations and things like that, you're analyzing what you need and just pick out the things that are important, okay? Real life experiences. So what I mean is make sure to include your life experiences is to show who you are. Everybody has similar background. Like if you're like everyone, for example, like if you grew up like low income, like a lot of people grew up low income, but what makes you unique as a person is your life experiences. Like, maybe you grew up low income, but then you help your family pick cans and stuff. Like if you ever see a can on the ground, you always pick it up and then you help recycle and things like that. That's your own personal experience. That's what makes you unique. That's what makes you different from somebody who grew up in a similar background as you. Okay, they may have their own different experiences, but that's what makes them unique. So, and a real important part is to show and don't tell. You always hear this, show and don't tell. What this means is that you're telling them your experience, you're showing them your experiences by through your writing. So there's two versions right here. This version is this, and this is from, this is just an essay. This is just essay examples that I got from online. This is version one is, I have always been interested in science, even from a young age. Since my family supported my interest enthusiastically, I continue to pursue it throughout school. As I've gotten older, though, my scientific endeavors have become increasingly complex. And then version number two, too young to enter the school science fair, I took to my family, force feeding different animal food to my siblings and parents. I graphed their favorite types. When I was only six, my parents have never forgiven me. My experience remained the family joke. Nevertheless, I have progressed from my dog food days, leaving taste tests for DNA gel electroforensics experiments. So you can see from the two examples, the first example, like it has fancy words, vocabulary, things like that, but it doesn't really show you who you are. Like anybody can write this. It doesn't really paint a picture of who that person is. Okay. But the version two, you can tell who that person is, who he or she is by seeing that how they love science so much that they experience on their family. They fed them dog food and things like that. That's their own personal, that's personal to themselves. And then you can see reactions like by writing this, you can start like imagining what the family's reactions are is. And like just reading this, like it get like it already makes me laugh a little bit. This one here is just like the first version is just like plain, it's simple, it's just what it is, but it doesn't do anything to you. It doesn't make me feel anything. All right. Any questions?
So I do have a question that a student posed to me. She wants to know, if you got accepted into multiple colleges or universities and you're not sure which one you're gonna go to, can you still apply for scholarships? And how should she go about showing evidence of the scholarship or the school she's going to? So Lang, if you know the answer, you can answer, or any other staff member.
So for applying scholarships, even if you haven't decided which scholarship you're gonna go to, that's fine. If they're asking for like verification, you could just show them your acceptance letter or acceptance email, and that would be your verification. If once you get admitted, once you decide which college you're gonna enroll and you send in your statement of intent, that's when, and if you do win that scholarship, they will probably ask for like further documentation, verification. And then that's when you will ask your school for like a verification letter, things like that. And that's when your school will be provided. And that's when, because you're not gonna get those money until you like are in the school, and then they'll send you that check, you know? So just because you haven't decided which college doesn't mean you don't apply. You just keep applying, and then just choose if they need a verification in the letter, just choose the one that you're leaning towards. And then you can always, and then if you do change your mind, you can always let them know that you changed school, but then you still have the verification letter for your new college. Hopefully that answers your question. All right. Any other questions?
Daisy just dropped in the chat, talk about how you overcame your challenges. I don't know if you want to elaborate on that, Daisy, for the students in the room.
Sure, I'll just talk about it real quick. So it was when Lang was talking about how everybody has their unique situations, and sometimes we all have a similar situation, like low income. But that's where you talk about what's specific about you, what makes you unique versus everyone else who probably grew up in the same kind of background as you. It's how you overcame those challenges that makes you stand out, that makes you different, right? So that's something very important for you to write on in your essays. And that's just what I wanted to add.
Yeah, overcoming challenges is always a great experience to write in your essays, because it shows the person reading that you're constantly changing, you're constantly learning and growing. You're as a person, and you're not stagnant or anything. So like that means that you're gonna change yourself, and maybe you're gonna change your community. All right. So next, this is just like a screenshot of like the top 10 most common scholarship essays. You can number one is like, how would the scholarship help you? And number two, how will you contribute to your community? Tell us about yourself, things like that. If you go on this website, Going Merry, and then I think if Dylan or Daisy or Dow, who I shared a URL, if you guys could type in the chat for the students. And then this website does have like scholarship examples of winners do, and you can read them. You can read an essay examples, things like that. But I just want to caution you about when you're reading winning essays, just be mindful that you're reading it and you're just taking what's of value. You don't copy it verbatim, because if you do that, it's kind of making your essay generic. Okay, but it's always a great idea to read winning essays just to see what they're asking for. Okay. Let me look at the chat real quick. Okay. All right. So that's those are the scholarship examples, essentials. Any questions before we move on? So the first one was knowing your deadlines, reading the prompt, knowing your audiences, and using real life experiences. Okay. All right, so we're gonna move on to the writing phase. All right, so the writing phase, it's just what I've learned in my time as college. I was an English major, so I did a lot of writing, and there's always like strategies they tell us in those in each of their classes, like, oh, this is the writing technique. But this writing technique is the one that stuck to me the most. But before we talk about that writing technique, I have a writing exercise challenge for everyone. So for 1 minute, write as many sentences as you can, and you can write about anything, all right? So I'm gonna give you 10 seconds to put up a Word doc, and mentors, Dylan, if you guys wanna do this, you guys can do this too. All right, so I'm gonna start the timer, all right? So for 1 minute, write as many sentences as you can. Write anything, okay? All right, the minute's up. Hopefully everyone was able to write a lot. So type in the chat, how many sentences were you able to write? Let's see, was it 1 or 2 sentences? 3 or 5, 6, 9, or 10 or plus more? So let's type in the chat, see who has written the most sentences. If you want, I'll let you guys know after everybody start typing, I'll let you know how many sentences I wrote. All right. 4, 4. All right.
Guys, that's pretty good.
All right, five. All right. So yeah, that's pretty good. Five. It's good. All right, you guys got some sentences going on. All right. I know a minute seems pretty short for sentences, but I know you guys got some sentences going on. Anybody got 10 or more? No? I'm gonna give you 5 seconds to answer if you have 10 or more. All right, so no one got 10 or more. So I actually got 13 sentences. You guys wanna know how I got those sentences? All right, these are my sentences. I like ice cream, the dog ran, I like pigs, I like to eat, I like to read, things like that. These are sentences. I didn't say you have to be like elaborate sentences, it's just sentences. You just need a subject, a verb, and an object. That's it. So I got 13 by just writing whatever. This is what I'm gonna expand upon in a little bit. Because because I told you guys you can write anything. Like, this is what you're gonna do when you're brainstorming, you write anything, okay? All right, so the writing technique I'm gonna talk about is the flowers paradigm. All right, so this writing technique was created by Dr. Betty S. Flowers. She's a former director of the Lyndon Baines Johnson Library and Museum, and she's a emeritus professor of English at the University of Texas at Austin. So she has a long career editing books and writing books and things like that. And then the flowers paradigm has been used by numerous writers, and then it's been used in like writing technique books and things like that. It's been included. So the flowers paradigms include 4 phases: the madman, the architect, the carpenter, and the judge. And I'm gonna expand on it in a bit. But essentially the madman is just, you just write whatever, and then write whatever that comes to your mind. And then the architect, you just put those things together and then put those things in order. And then the carpenters is where you start filling in those blanks. And then the judge is where you proofread, okay? But it's just what she wrote. There's a little quote that she talks about how, like, when you're a writer and then you're a writer and then you talk about how people are like, oh, I'm stuck, I can't write anything. Her quote's like, when you get stuck, it is that two competing energies are locked horn to horn, pushing against each other. One is the energy that what I'll call your madman. He is full of ideas, writes crazily, and perhaps rather sloppily. He gets carried away by enthusiasm or anger, and if really let loose, could turn out 10 pages an hour. And then the second kind of energy is the critical energy, what is called the judge. He's been educated and knows a sentence fragment when he sees one. He peers over your shoulders and says, that's trash, with such authority that the madman loses his crazy confidence and shrivels up. Like, because you know the judge is right. After all, he speaks with the voice of like your most imperious English teacher. But like for all his sharpness of his eye, like he can't create anything. So as a judge, he can't create. He's just like picking at the madman, you know? So that's why she separate the writing into 4 phases, all right? So the next one, the madman is the brainstorming phases, okay? You're gonna write whatever you want, and you're gonna write like crazy, all right? You can do lists, you can write lists, you can write sentences, you can just write phrases, things like that. You can do like those web, where you circle a word, and then you just do like spider webs, things like that. And you can write about anything. I have some few examples for scholarships: your idea, experience, high school experience, your home experience, your friends, your family, your accomplishment, your failures, etc. Write about anything. If you think it's something's gonna be useful, you write it. Even if it's not useful, write it. If it just pops in your mind, just write it. Because you know how, like a madman, their brain jumps everywhere. That's what you're gonna be doing. Your brain's gonna be jumping everywhere. You're not gonna be thinking about spelling, grammars, or punctuation. That's not the madman. That's not what he's gonna be worried about. That's the judge. Let him deal with that when it's on time. For now, you're just writing whatever, okay? If you want, you can set a timer so then you can know when to stop. But for now, you're just writing anything, okay? So this is, you're letting, because at the madman, you're letting your energy flow things like that. And then you're just getting your ideas together. All right, the next one is the architect. So the architect, he's the one that he's sorting the ideas that was written by the madman. So he's putting them in order, okay? That means, so he's putting them in order like from beginning, middle, and end. He's making that kind of like essay structure that we've been taught. But the architect, as an architect, you're not gonna need anything. You're not gonna use everything that the madman write. It's okay to choose, and it's okay to throw things away. Like if you know that this idea is not gonna be part of your, contribute to your essay, just leave it out, okay? And you're arranging these ideas into it makes it like I said, beginning, middle, and end. And then, so you're it's kind of like you're making an, this is right here, you're making an outline now, okay? And then, right here, you're just putting those ideas in order. You're not actually writing yet. You're not worrying about sentence structure or anything yet, okay? Next, we have the carpenter, okay? So the carpenter is essentially where you really start writing your essay. This is where you start, your sentence structure is important, things like that. You're writing the ideas that you put together in the architect phase. So like in your intro, whatever you put in your intro, you're writing those out. And then all your sentences are logic, and all your sentences make sense and they're logically and gracefully flow into the next sentences. And this is where your sentences are written out clearly, but it's written out clearly, but you're still writing fast and you're not editing or anything. Even if like you spell a word wrong and things like that, just don't worry about it. That's the judge is gonna worry about it. You're just worry about getting your ideas across and make sure all the words, your ideas are flowing, okay? And like it says right here, if you're stuck, jump to a different section. It's just like in a carpenter when they're building a house, they don't just go from one side of the house to the other. They do this side of the house. Then if they're finished with this one, they go to the other side of the house. So they're jumping all over the place. So for you, you should be doing similar things. If you're writing an intro and then you're stuck in an intro or you can't even write an intro, just go to your body. Just go to your body paragraph, your first body paragraph, and just write something right there. If not, if you're stuck right there, just go to, maybe you're writing the conclusion is better and then you just go to there, but you're jumping all over the place, okay? So when the carpenter is finished, you should have an essay that's smooth and watertight, but it's smooth. That means that if you can read it, but it's not gonna mean that it's clean or anything like that, okay? The next is the judge, okay? He's a nitpicking know-it-all. And it's where the judge and you have fun. That means he's gonna worry about your punctuation, spelling, grammars, and tones, things like that. Are you transitioning between paragraphs? You have transition verbs. Is this verb a strong verb? Or you wanna expand your vocabulary, things like that. So this is where they're checking your if your sentences are grammatically correct, or you're using commas, things like that. This is, they're using for, the judge is the quality control guy, and he's making sure everything is correct, and you finish editing everything. A great help for the judge is if you guys download Grammarly. Grammarly is pretty helpful in editing your paper, and then that actually helps you as the judge finding misspelled words or making sure each sentence structure, the subject matches the object, things like that. But once you finish with the judge, that doesn't mean that you're done. Okay, if you're done with the judge, you can always go back to the carpenter and see if maybe you want to look at it again, your essay again. Maybe there's some part that you want to change, things like that. So just make sure, just know that this doesn't mean that just because you finished with the judge, this means you're done with your essay. Okay. It just means that you're done with your first draft. Okay. And for the judge is after you're done with the first draft, it's your proofreading draft, and it's always best to read it out loud. Once you're, if you're a judge, if you're correcting your grammar and everything, if you read it out loud, you're pronouncing each word correctly. So if there's a misspelled word that's not misspelled, but it's not the correct word, you can know by just reading it out loud. If you have like issues, or you're kind of like, sometimes you dread reading your own work out loud, you can have someone else read it for you, proofread it. You can have a brother or sister or a friend read it. Or, and then you can also have your English teacher read it too. If they have time, they can read it. You can just have them check it out. But like I said, the more people that you have that proofread your work, the more your work will come out and look a little bit nicer. Because if one person doesn't understand it, that means maybe just that one person. But if multiple persons having a hard time with your essay, that means there's something wrong with your essay, okay? That means it has to go back. Maybe you're going to go back to the carpenter stage and start writing. Or maybe you're going to go to the architect. Maybe you got to go back to the architect. Or maybe you even have to go back to the madman and just start writing new tips, okay? All right, any questions right here? I've just talked about what I've learned and when I was in college, the madman, where you write whatever is on your mind, you don't worry about anything. You're writing anything that comes to your mind, okay? Even if it doesn't have to do with your essay, your general essay, just keep writing it. Maybe you can still use it. The architect is to you're putting your ideas in order and you're choosing the most significant ideas out of there. It's gonna make your essay stand out. You're just gonna choose those ideas and you're gonna put it in a beginning, middle, and end. And then the carpenter is gonna come in and start filling in the blanks. He's gonna start making those ideas into sentences. After the carpenter is done, the judge is gonna come in and correct everything, okay? All right, any questions? If there's no questions, that's it for my little writing guide. We're gonna do a writing session. And then Gav, you can take over.
Yeah, let me go ahead and I'll share the presentation real quick. And that way I can play some music while we do our writing. All right. Present. And share the right one. All right. Okay. Let's see. If I just do this, can you still all see this? Is it full screen?
Yep.
Sweet. Awesome. Okay. Absolutely. So we were just right here and Mr. Lang went over each one of these sections. Thank you, Mr. Lang, for teaching. That's something I learned new. So thank you. And so we're going to go by and I'm going to play the timer. I'm going to play some music and we're going to work on each of these sections. Now I'm going to type the prompt in the chat real quick. Let's see if I can minimize this window a bit. And the prompt is just gonna come straight off of, if you remember how I shared with you the general application. You got it, you already have it, Lang? Because I have the one straight off of the-
Say it again, Gav.
So I have the prompt, I just copied and pasted straight off of the application, the general application for the SCUSD scholarships for the 750 word essay. Did you want to use that prompt or did you have something else in mind?
No, they could, if the students, I mean, most essay asks for short-term and long-term goals and personal challenges. They could just have those, start thinking about those, because even if they don't use it for most essays on the district scholarship are asking for those and about the cumulative volume. Even if they don't use it, this one of those is going to be part of the scholarships.
Perfect. Okay, so I just copied and pasted in the chat, everyone. This is the prompt you're going to be using for this writing activity, okay? So short-term and long-term goals, personal challenges, community involvement, including future involvement, okay? That's coming straight off the website. So you can use what you do today. Once you end up refining it, you can use this exactly for any of the scholarships you want to apply for, okay? Cool. So with that said, let me go to the next slide. And let me start the music up and then we'll get going. Let's go here. Okay, can you all, let me know if you can hear. Is that good? Cool. Okay, let me go ahead and play. I'll present. All right, there we go. Okay, is everything working? Just want to make sure audio's good. All right, I got the thumbs up from Daisy. Okay, all right, timer's going. I've started. Remember, you're on the madman step. For that prompt in the chat, y'all, go ahead and start your madman journey. Okay, get everything out on paper. Thoughts, ideas, doesn't have to be refined yet. Just like Mr. Lang did when he typed out those 10 quick, crazy sentences. Just get it all out on paper for now. We'll see you in 9 minutes. two more minutes. Timer's up. All right. We've hit the 10-minute mark on the madman phase. Wow. Good job. Great stuff. Hope you enjoyed that and got everything out. Let's move on to the next slide. Break. Got to always, when you're writing, you don't want to hit writer's block. You want to stretch your typing hands out, stretch your mind out, take a quick break. I'm going to give you a 4-minute break just to get up. Highly encourage you to stretch out. Go get a glass. I'm going to fill my water up. Go get a glass of water.
I forgot to mention, you take these breaks in between these phases just to get yourself out of the phases you got. So we just finished the madman phase. We're taking this break just to get out of the madman, and then you start focusing on the architect.
Yes, that's true. Remember that we're going to switch mindsets each time we switch it up into the different sections. So clear your mind of that last mindset. We're going to take a 4-minute break. All right, timer's on the board, and we will be back in a quick second for the next one. I'll go over the slide for the next, the architect next, just so you have a quick review. All right, okay, 4-minute break. Continue.
Running down the street so I don't get fed. Trying not to stress so my world just crack. But it's hard to relax. You know you're not in control. In control. In control. In control. Thank you.
supposed to say? What's impossible, they forgot. This world keeps spinning and with each new day, I can feel a change in everything. And as the surface breaks, reflections fade. But in some ways they remain the same. And as my mind begins to spread its wings, there's no stopping curiosity. I wanna turn the whole thing upside down. I'll find the things they say just can't be found. I'll share this love I find with everyone. We'll sing and dance to Mother Nature's song. I don't want this feeling to go away.
All right. I don't know if I want to hear the cops every time that timer goes off. That's okay. All right. So let's go ahead to, yes, this is my playlist. All right. But guys, add some songs, y'all, as long as they're not explicit. Gabriel added one, but it's explicit, so I'm kind of afraid to play it. I haven't heard it before. But everyone, let's go ahead and move on to the next section. Let me go ahead and go back real quick. This is the next one we're going to be tackling, the architect, y'all. This is the one where we're sorting out our ideas that are just out on the paper from that first session. You don't have to choose everything. You can also take some stuff out, like Lang said, beginning, middle, and end. So start thinking about some form, okay? And don't worry about the sentence structure too much. Before we move on to the actual writing assignment, is there anything you wanted to recap from the architect, Mr. Lang?
Yeah, so this is, you're not writing sentences yet, just so you guys know. This is not what you're writing yet. You're just putting your ideas in order, okay? So you're trying to find out which part, which idea is good for the beginning, which is good for the middle, which is good for the ending, okay? So maybe if you're talking about short-term goal, long-term goal, and then what you're gonna do with the money that you for the awards, you can separate those into those three categories.
Got it. All right. And before we continue, students, are there any questions? Drop them in the chat. Before we get started with the architect, I'll just give you one last look at that right there, sorting out our ideas, just refining it a little bit more, okay? All right, so we already had this, we had our break, now architect, okay? And as we go on, we're getting a little bit less and less in each time, so this is 7 minutes, okay? Let's go ahead, and if I don't hear anything, I don't see the chat, so if there's anything, let me know. Let's go ahead and do it. Timer is started. Let us go ahead. All right, let's see. Thank you. A minute and a half left. Wrap it up, wrap it up. Seconds. All right, hands up, don't shoot. Watch out, cops are coming. All right, here we go. So we just finished architect. All right, let me just get in the chat real quick. Just want to see, how is everyone doing? Students, let me know in the chat. Doing good or need some more help? Let me know how everyone is doing. Just curious to see where you're at. Do you have enough time for these? We're gonna wrap up, continuing with this writing exercise, but cool. Thank you, Jesse. Chilling, I like it. Good. Thank you, Guadalupe. Perfect. All right, cool. Awesome. All right, we're going to keep continuing with it as we fine-tune. Remember, we just finished architect. That means we have two more. Carpenter and the judge, all right? Which means let's get to the carpenter. But before we do, we have a little break. All right, Makai's doing decent. Perfect. If you have any suggestions, let us know. If you have any questions, let us know. But let's go ahead and take our 4-minute brain break, mind break, before we head into the next one. All right. Let's go ahead and make sure you're still awake. I've been playing some calm music. Let's make sure you're still awake. If you're dozing off.
You can barely hear it, Gav.
Oh, let me turn it up. Let me know when it's good. It's different on my end. Good. Oh, wait, it stopped. Rising up back on the street, did my time, took my chances. With the distance, now I'm back on my feet. Just a man and his will to survive. So many times it happens too fast. You trade your passion for glory. Cut it there. I don't know if I want to hear all the sirens. All right, so we're going to go ahead and move on to the next section. This was listed for 20 minutes, but we're going to cut it down to 10, make sure we get you all out of here on time, in a timely manner. This is the carpenter, okay? Before we do that, quick recap what the carpenter is, in case you forgot. This is where you really begin writing your essay. Sentence structure, okay? So let's start thinking about that. Writing your ideas together in a logical order, okay? So placement of your ideas, leading logically and great, so some transitions there. Clearly written, grammar, okay? So remember, this is just refining it just one step farther. And then at the very end, the judge is the very final, final one. Okay. So this one is pretty polished. Not all the way, but it's pretty polished. Okay. Any questions about Carpenter before we get on that one?
I want to just add something at this point. Yep. So yeah, just make sure as you're doing this exercise that you really fine tune. You make sure that you have like a topic sentence, you know, as you go into your detailed sentences, and that you have a really good, strong transition sentence, like Gavin had said earlier, into your following paragraphs. Sometimes it may not come up right as you're writing it, because sometimes, like when I'm writing papers, it's not until after I've gotten like all of the ideas out that I'll go back to my paragraphs and then maybe add a transition sentence, or, you know, tweak my topic sentence or whatever. So, but just be mindful of the structure and everything. Just, it adds more of a flow and stuff like that. So.
All right. Thank you for that, Ms. Natasha. Okay. You guys got Carpenter ready to go. I'm going to reduce this to 10 minutes. Let's go right there. All right. Oh, nope, too far back. 10. All right, here we go. About 10 minutes on the clock. And let's go ahead and get started. Of course, it starts over. There we are, 10 minutes. Here we go. Finding it just a little bit more. Nothing too much. Polishing is at the very end, just a little bit more refined. And just keep in mind the word limit now, you probably want to think of that, is 750. Okay, so just think of that at this stage. Go ahead, Ian.
I actually said you don't need to worry about the word limit yet. I feel like that's pretty good, Judge.
And we got a question in the chat. They just want to know what we're talking about. Like what exactly are writing about?
So right now is the Carpenter phase, and you're just writing. So you already have your ideas from your madman, and then you put it in them in beginning, middle, and end. During the architect phase, this is the Carpenter's phase, and this is where you're just writing out sentences now. You have those ideas. Now put those ideas into sentences, and then get the make the sentences flow from this sentences to the sentences. Make sure the paragraph reads fluently.
Yes, Carpenter phase.
This is the Carpenter's phase. When you're writing sentences, don't worry about spelling or grammars or things like that. That's for the judge, okay? Just keep writing.
And if you didn't see the prompt, it is in the chat. If you head back there, it's the prompt for all the most of the SCUSD scholarships.
Everybody loves the sunshine. Everybody loves the sunshine. My life, my life, my life, my life, in the sunshine. Everybody loves the sunshine. Sunshine, everybody loves the sunshine. Sunshine.
Halfway through this section. My life in the sunshine. Two minutes. Reduce it a bit, get you out of here on time. Small little break. Sirens blaring at us this time. I like it. Okay, here we go. That's the carpenter. Now it is 5 o'clock. What that means is we're gonna still be here. We're gonna finish out the judge phase. But with that said, if you have to go, all good, no problem. Thank you for being with us today. Remember to hit us up on the YDSS Mentor website. We're gonna have this recording available for you in case you arrived late, as well as our contact information. You can reach out to any of us, ask us any questions about college and career, but we're going to finish out today. Let's go with a quick break. This time we're going to go with, let's go with like 2 minutes. All right. Just a quick one just to, stretch out a little bit. There we go. All right. Let's go with a quick break. All right. There we go. Want to make sure we get out of here on time so everyone's good. Make sure my internet is working still. Nope, not wanting to play. Come on, music. There we go. Quick minute. And get ready for the judge, the final one. Wake you up a little bit. All right, 30 seconds. Stretch out. Stretch your hands. Goodness, I'm sorry about that. Wow, what an abrupt closure. Okay, anyways, let's go ahead and let's review judge really quick so we can close out with it. The judge, this is the polish, right? This is the final coating, all right? It's going to have punctuation, emphasis on spelling, grammar, even tone, okay? Transitions between paragraphs, really honing on those. Changing up some of those verbs and so on. You could use Grammarly. That's a good website if you want to kind of final check some stuff. Checking the technical points, comma splices, all those things that you guys learn in English class. You're being the judge here, quality control, okay? So that's pretty much it. I mean, is there anything I'm mislaying about judge you wanted to add on?
That's pretty good. Everything is there. And then after you do the judge, it doesn't mean you're done. I mean, that's just your first draft, but you can have somebody, you can still read it out loud, your paper, and then that's still, when you read it out loud, you can still, you'll find some error, you can still correct that. That's pretty helpful during the judge phase.
Very true. You're not done. That's your first draft. So let's go ahead and let's put five, you need 5 minutes or you want to do the full 10? All right, let's do 5 here. Let me adjust it. 5:30. Okay, here we go. Polish phase. And remember, this is first draft, so you can always go back, have someone read it, out loud yourself. And really hone this down, all right? Okay, so here we go with 5 minutes on the clock. Let us do it.
You're gonna turn September back on, right?
Gotcha, Tasha.
April.
It's hard to jump back and forth on the music thing between my phone and my laptop, but let's see if it'll work.
No, but honestly, you should pick a song that they can actually like think to, you know. So
that's okay. I'll turn September on a little low. There we go.
Cool. Dance party.
This is your celebration phase, judge, as well. So there you go. Through any of those little commas, run all sentences, get that grammar all good. We did it, y'all.
Thank God we did it.
Good job today.
I know we could.
Once we're all done, we're going to go over just a few resources we wanted to share with you. You already have our mentor website, and we'll be able to close out. And you should be on your way, and we'll go over any questions if you have them.
I get the spill, then break the mill. Used to walk around with a big old head, little bit. Here we go now, oh my. On the road like roll.
We've got about a minute left. Finish up those corrections. Under a minute.
Bam. I'm out here working while you posting on the ground. I don't need no one to tell me what I am. I just winged it in this new all over plan. Got it, me. I don't lose. I got things I'ma do. I don't need no excuse. They gon' copy the flow like Kinko's. I'm not green to the game like CeeLo. Just my team didn't need no cheat code. I'ma go back to my people like we did it.
Here we go. Final countdown timer of today. Let's see what this ringtone is. Oh, same one. Never mind. I had some hope. Never mind. All right. Okay. We go here.
You got your next slide, yeah.
Yep. Let me exit out of there. We just finished Judge. Amazing stuff. Oh, don't start that again. Nice. Congratulations. We did it. We got there. That's your first draft. As she throws down a cup of, she's going to have to clean that up, by the way. She thinks she's getting off the hook. No, she's going to have to clean that up. Nah, but great job. Congratulations. Celebration time, but not all the way. Remember, this is just one part of your scholarship journey, is writing it. That's your first draft, right? You always want to go back, double check, have someone else read it. Like Mr. Lang said, read it aloud. And see how it sounds to you. So, but you are on your way. Great job today. Did amazing. Let's go ahead and ask or share any questions, students. If you have anything you wanted to ask us this time, let's do it. Well, we kind of set up some resources we want to share with you. Who wants to go ahead and share screen with some of those mentor website and just kind of run through those?
I can go over the mentor website.
Sweet. Awesome.
While you're setting up stuff.
You guys want to cover it again?
Oh, you guys already? Okay.
Yeah, we did kind of discuss it in the beginning, but we can drop the link in there again because that's a great place for you guys to connect with the mentors. And again, that resource page is full of links and information that will support you with some of your questions. So it's a good one-stop shop to get everything answered regarding college.
Most definitely. Yes, let's go ahead and let me drop that in there for y'all.
Or drop it in the chat.
Go here.
And if at this time no one has any questions, I can go over the senior survey B.
Perfect. Thank you, Daisy. Yep. Let's go ahead